Last time on My Wife and Kids.
How long does it take you to gas up your tank?
During peak periods, I average between 12 and 14 minutes.
Just give me a car. Just give me the car. I'm going to stuff you in a trunk. Come on, let's go.
All right, Junior. Let's rumble.
You're going to Tokahana, so you might as well get ready.
God, not Tokahana.
We're sitting with the China family.
In the world, they sit me next to this one. I wish I could change my seat.
We don't have it at the gas station. We have it at the gas station. Now, will you please let it go, baby? Come on. Don't let us hold them. Give me a kiss. Please. Thank you.
Okay.
Hey! Stop it! I'm sorry. You know how kids are.
Yes, I know how some kids are.
Oh, thank you.
Where's my drink?
I only have two hands.
See that? Now she's messing with me, Jay.
Well, you just cut it out, babe. Deep breaths. Have to spin.
Your children smell like fish.
Yeah, well, your children look like squirrels.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, at least my children are well behaved.
Well, you gotta be well behaved when you look like squirrels. That's how you get a chance to beg for nuts.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. Steve, please. We don't want you know what to flare up.
You're right, you're right. God, these chairs are hard.
I can't believe I'm sitting here eating dinner with someone who annoys the hell out of me.
Neither can I.
So, Jason, how was school today?
It was great, Father. I won the role of Jesus in God's spell.
Oh!
Big deal. Who can't spell God?
And how was your day, Lisa?
Oh, terrific, Father. I was nominated for student council.
Again? Oh, that is wonderful. We are so proud of you.
So, Michael Richard Kyle Jr., how was your day at school today?
Well, although I got my penis caught in my zipper twice, I almost got an A on my test.
You what?
You hear that, everybody? My son almost got an A on his test. What'd you get?
A D. 3 letters away from an A.
Oh, talk about close.
She just sent me a drink.
Oh.
The hostess.
You're losing your mind.
I saw what I saw, and I know what I seen.
There you go.
Hold on 1 second. This seems to be a sip short of a full drink.
I do not understand.
You sipped my drink. You sipped it.
Zipper?
No, not zipper. You sip my drink.
Oh! Thirsty. Thank you.
No. Take it back and get me another one and don't charge me for it.
Yes, it's charging you.
No. Don't charge me.
Yes. Everything a charge at the Tokahana.
No.
Yes.
No charge.
Charge it.
No. Charge, no.
Charge it.
No. You, that's your drink.
Yes, sir.
I hope lightning hits me and I die.
Charge it.
No charging. I don't want you to charge me.
Yes, does there seem to be a problem,
yes,
sir?
Yes. Apparently your hostess here has a drinking problem. She sipped my drink twice.
What is he talking about, Elaine?
I have no idea, Larry.
Mr. Miyagi.
You have no idea, then why is your lipstick on my glass?
You gave me sip, remember? Didn't he give me sip?
He clearly gave her a sip, yes.
I'm very sorry about this whole misunderstanding. I'll have another beverage sent right over.
Thank you. Please don't let Crouching Tiger, Sipping Dragon bring it, okay?
Is there anything else I can help you with?
Yes. As a matter of fact, they charged us $60 for a sweatshirt. I know that's got to be a mistake.
Yes, thank you for bringing this to my attention. These are supposed to be $72. I'll have it reflected on your bill.
Well, you handled that well, didn't you? Are you satisfied now? Can we stop arguing with people? Can we have a civilized meal, please?
Yes,
that would be really nice.
I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry. Can I have a kiss?
Yeah.
Okay, well, hopefully the food will be good. I'm going to really try. Enjoy.
That's repulsive. What are you doing?
I'm seducing that girl with my mating call by licking my lips. Girls love it.
They only love it if you can lick your eyebrows. Wait a minute.
You're not gonna do that tambourine and whistle thing, are
you? No, I'm not.
Good.
Excuse me, sir, could I have a word, please?
Oh, I understand, but there aren't any other tables available. He asked to move his seat.
I thought that's what you wanted.
It is what I wanted, but I wanted to be the one to ask. But he asked, and I make me look like I'm the bad guy. I need to go fix it.
Oh, no. We're not going to make this thing any bigger or sillier than it already is. You know what I wish, Michael? I wish you would just go apologize to that man so we can all eat in peace, yes.
Why should I apologize? He was in the wrong, clearly in the wrong.
It's called being the bigger man, Michael.
I like that, Jay. I could live with that. Be the bigger man. I like the way that sounds.
Yeah, well, go on
my resume.
Come on,
Michael Kyle, the bigger man.
Yeah.
Excuse me, Mr. Tyler. I'd like to offer an apology. I was way out of line at the gas station, and I'd like to apologize. Truce?
Sure. I'll be the bigger man.
No. I was the bigger man. I offered the apology.
Excuse me, it takes a bigger man to accept and forgive. Therefore, technically, I am the bigger man. You are, therefore, the supplicant.
Oh, no, I am not. No. See, because technically, you accepted my apology, which makes you the succulent one.
I rescind my acceptance.
Too late.
It is never too late.
It's too late.
No, it isn't.
I don't want to hear it.
Hey, everybody.
Well, it looks like we are having a good time over here. So, is everyone ready to eat? All right, good. I am your chef. My name is Nabu Hankatora.
You're not Japanese.
Yes, I am.
You're being so rude.
He's not Japanese. We're in a Japanese restaurant. I want a Japanese chef. It does matter. Everybody else have Japanese chefs. Look, right there. He's Japanese. I bet that hostess has something to do with this. I'm not good enough for a Japanese chef.
I am Japanese.
What part of Japan are you from?
Downtown.
Well, we'll do something fancy with the knives. Of course he's good with knives. He looks like he's good with a spoon and fork, too.
So is everyone ready to order?
I want shrimp, mister.
Please, call me Nabu-san.
I want shrimp too, Nabu-san.
I want chicken cooked in canola oil. Not that fatty stuff, Nabu-san.
And what can I get for you, sir?
You can get me a Japanese chef, Nabu-san.
Maybe you can recommend something, Nabu-san.
I certainly can. I recommend the Imperial Dinner. It comes with your choice of chicken, shrimp, a steak, or lobster.
You hear that? Lobster. It sounds like Ricardo Montalban. Lobster. If he was Japanese, it'd be Rostar. I'll have the Imperial with Rostar.
And we'll have the Imperial dinner too, please, but we'll have it with Slake. Slake. Me.
Glass for me?
No, thank you. I don't want to be in the show.
Come on, baby, be a
star. Okay. I'm holding up the glass. Go ahead, do a little trick.
Okay, here we go.
You're burning me, you idiot!
That's why I love this place. Not only is the food great, but there's always a show.
Well, here's your chance to be in the show.
Are you insane?
Yeah, I'm insane. It's insane when I do it, but when he does it, it's entertainment.
Was it excellent? You don't.
What?
Come on.
Hey. Wait. Have my civilized dinner. Remember, Michael? Kids. Stuart, Mary, and Tyler, I want you to get a hold of yourself. I am not getting up at 4 a.m. to apply that ointment.
Oh, I hate you.
Marion.
John Wayne's name was Marion.
Yeah, he didn't have any rights.
Yeah. Would you send the Coca-Cola to that young lady with my compliments?
Aren't you worried I'm going to drink some of it?
That would only enhance the fantasy.
You are a creepy child.
Okay, we'll start off with some chicken and some stir-fried vegetables.
chicken.
He's got more chicken than I do.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he does. Look at that. Mine is mostly sprouts. Anybody want to share this chicken? It's more than I can eat.
That's it. I'm going to take a walk.
So, how is everyone's food?
Well, let's look.
Baby, not better than a talk with your mouth full.
Hello, Mommy. Delicious.
I'll be back in a moment, dear.
Balls at your sister.
I didn't do it. Chip and Dale over there did it.
Junior, stop it right now.
Tell Dale to stop her.
Me? Jason, you put that straw down this instant. Claire, that's enough.
Claire, stop what I mean.
Stop it. I said stop it.
You two, Lisa, stop it.
You know what? It's not ladylike.
They got me.
Hey, could you turn that radio off? I'll give you $10. I'll give you $20.
You got it.
Come on, come on. Hey, could you turn the water off on me, please?
Oh.
Not so hard.
Yeah.
Right there.
Listen, I want to apologize for my actions earlier today at the gas station. I was wrong in monopolizing the space and keeping you waiting.
I appreciate you saying that. I really do.
What do you say we start fresh? Hey, that water is cold, isn't it?
It's deep, too. What I said about the kids being squirrels and stuff like that. I mean, that wasn't nice. The kids shouldn't be involved. Can I get one from my friend? Kids shouldn't be in. That was disgusting. He walked out of here without even washing his hands.
Go in. No, sayonara, brother.
You Japanese too?
Till midnight.
Men's, all right. He made a men's room very uncomfortable.
What?
The guy totally violated good urinal etiquette.
What is good urinal etiquette?
Well, look, it's an unwritten male law that if I'm using a urinal, the next guy has to use the urinal furthest away from me. Mm-hmm. There's supposed to be a minimum of one empty urinal on both flanks. It's the comfort zone, or the splash zone, if you like. This pig doesn't even wash his nasty hands.
You know, they changed the sauce. It's tangier.
Okay, it's time now for the main course.
Can't wait to get a hold of that lobster. It'll make everything better, too.
All right, we got lobster right here. And we got steak right here.
No. The lobster goes over here, and the steak goes over there.
No problem, my pal. Here you go, buddy boy. Watch out. There you go.
Wait a minute, you're kidding, right?
Is there something wrong with your lobster?
Is there something wrong with my lobster, he asked.
That's what I said, is there something wrong with your lobster?
Yeah, I'd say considering the fact that you didn't wash your nasty hands and you put them on my lobster, there's something very wrong with my lobster.
What are you talking about? I didn't wash my hands, I always wash my hands.
You didn't wash them this time.
You didn't wash your hands, Daddy? That's disgusting.
Stay out of it.
Stupid.
I've had just about enough of you.
And I had enough of you too, salty fingers.
And I had enough of both of you. And so have I. Sit down, Michael Stewart. Sit down.
He put pee-pee fingers on my lobster. Oh, that's what it is.
Naboo will make you another lobster, won't you, Naboo?
Yes, no problem.
Thank you. Now I want all of you to sit down, shut your mouths, and I want you to enjoy each other's company before I strangle each one of you.
You still have my steak?
Lonely. Enjoy.
Man, I cannot eat another bite.
Me too, Noodle-san. Everything was delicious.
Ay, muchas gracias. I mean, como arigato. Thank you, everybody.
Bye-bye. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Stop it. Hold it. Stop the singing.
What's the matter, dear?
What's the matter? He's not singing.
That's right.
Why won't you sing happy birthday to my wife?
Because I don't want to sing happy birthday to your wife.
Why not?
I don't have to explain to you. This is America. I have my rights to not sing if I don't want to sing.
What's so hard about singing? Is his voice that bad?
No, I have a beautiful voice. It's actually falsetto. I choose not to sing to your wife.
You will.
No, I will not.
You will.
I will not.
Now hear this. I'm not asking you to bake the cake, but I'm asking you to sing to my wife. It's un-American not to sing to my wife. It is. It's un-American, and it's common courtesy to
sing
to someone.
Well, it's common courtesy to pull your car up at the gas station so other people can use the phone.
There we go with the gas station again.
And why did you stand next to me at the urinal and violate the splash zone?
Oh, my God.
Why did you touch my crustacean with your pee-pee fingers? Oh, and why am I spending so much money to eat dinner with people who I don't like, huh?
That's it.
Why?
I've had about enough of this. Kids, let's...
Please, I'm very sorry. Please don't.
Goodbye, good riddance. Let him go, please.
Yeah, I take umbrage, sir, and I blame you for not moving us when I asked to.
There was nothing that I could do.
Excuse me, Anne! I assure that neither I nor anyone else in the Park's electrical community. And there are many of us. We're a tight little group.
You hear that, Jim? He's a professional pain in the ass.
None of us is ever coming back here again.
Please, let me pay for your dinner. It's on the house. It's the least I can do.
Well,
yeah, what about my check?
Here you go.
Did you see how Dad threw that guy in the coin?
Yeah, Dad, that was funny.
That's what he did to me.
I don't want any of you admiring that kind of behavior. Michael, I can't believe you did that.
What was I supposed to do? The guy charged me for a lobster that I didn't eat, a drink that the hostess drank. He charged me for a birthday cake, that sweatsuit, and a bunch of sodas that I didn't even buy.
Clear that mystery. Junior kept sending drinks to some girl.
Not some girl. Kathy. And it worked, too. I gave her my number. She gave me one back.
No, idiot. She gave you yours back.
That doesn't make any sense. Why was she all flirting with me and taking my free sodas if she wasn't interested?
Because she was practicing the art of being a woman. And you know what happens when they get really good at it? They can make you take the whole family to Tokohana's.
Very funny. Come on, let's go.
Yeah, come on. I want to watch the game today.
Oh, where's the valet?
What is the light still doing on in the car?
He's smoking a cigar in my car?
Hey. Wow, what a game. Jordan scored 100 points in triple overtime and won.
Me for a birthday cake, that sweatshirt, and like 8 Cokes that I didn't even buy.
I gave her my number, she gave me hers back.
No, she gave you... No.